this video, we're going to go over the VLOOKUP formula in Excel. Now, VLOOKUP stands for vertical lookup, meaning that whatever it is you're looking up, all the references will be up and down. They won't be horizontal. We'll go over horizontal in a different video. But the VLOOKUP, you're going to look up and down what you're looking for. And when Excel looks, one thing to remember before we get started is whatever you're looking up needs to be on the further left column that you're of the data set that you're referencing. So, for example, so we want to look up what product was sent to Omaha. So we want to say equals VLOOKUP, and our lookup value is going to be Omaha. Now we're going to want to put that in quotations because it's text. It's not numerical like Excel is used to doing. The table array will be a range of columns that we want Excel to look through. So we're going to just highlight all of these columns. You can also just highlight a section, but whenever possible to avoid errors, it's just better to highlight all the columns. The next question is the column index number. So Excel is not going to reference your column headers. It's actually just going to assign a number to each column. So for example, the first column is always 1. In this case, product number, column D would be our second column, or 2, and then 3, 4, 5, and 6, all the way over to column H. So we need to know which product was sent to Omaha. So we're going to just choose number 3 for column E. And then it asks us if we want to choose approximate or exact match. So I prefer to use exact match. I've actually never used approximate match, or I've never needed to. Approximate match will bring back the first value that it sees that is close to what you want. And that a lot of times can just give you errors. So I like to do exact match. So we close our parentheses and we can see that a hat was sent to Omaha. So if we look up Omaha here, where's Omaha? And you can see that yes, indeed, a hat was sent to Omaha. Now to illustrate, if you forget to do the parentheses, or excuse me, if you forget to do the quotation marks, you're gonna see here what happens. You get an error because it's not sure what to do. So I'm just gonna undo that. So the next thing is we wanna look up the product price of product number 32480. Now, that we can just type as a number. So we're gonna do VLOOKUP 32480. And we want to choose the range. Now, we're going to actually look up. We're going to have a slightly different range because, again, we need for the product or for the item that we're looking up to be on the further left column of our data range. So we're going to choose, we're going to start the range with column D, so D through H, and we need the price, which in this case will be 1, 2, 3, will be the fourth column, and choose false. And you see now that 32480 was $30. Now we want to look up where product number 32479 was delivered to. Well, that puts us in a pickle because 32479 is to the right of the location. So the easiest thing to do in this circumstance, you can either move this or I'm just going to copy it, because if I drag the entire column, then that'll mess up our other two formulas. So we just copied and pasted that column over to anywhere on the right of the product number. So we just simply type our formula again. So equals VLOOKUP, and we're going to do product number to the new store location, and that is 6 columns. Oops, we don't want that. So 32479. Choose our range again. Column 6 and false. And we see that product number 32479 was delivered to the Mobile location. So hope this helps you with your VLOOKUP formula. And if you enjoyed this video, I would like to know right away when the next ones come out. Please make sure to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.